In this video, we'll look at determining credit given for partial payment of an invoice. Occasionally, a customer may pay only a portion of the total amount due on an invoice. If this partial payment is made within the discount period, they're entitled to a discount on the portion of the invoice that is paid. And to help us see how that works, let's look at an example here. We have terms of 210, a 2% discount if paid within 10 days of the invoice date. So here's how those percentages play out. The invoice amount is 100%. The discount is allowing 2% reduction on that invoice amount, which means the net amount paid is the complement. 100% minus the discount gives us 98%. And if we follow this through, say an invoice is $100 with the terms of 210, a payment of $98 will pay off a $100 invoice. 2% of 100 is $2, and so that's where the 98 is coming from. Well, let's look at an example then. We have an invoice of $100, terms of 210, and a partial payment of $50 is made. The customer is depleting their pocketbook of $50, but what is it equal to on the accounting side for the owner or the business that this payment is being made to? In other words, what's the given credit? So here we'll lay out the relationship of how that 2% discount plays out, the credit given. If there hadn't been a discount period, would be 100%, the full amount that the invoice is requiring, but they're entitled to a discount because they paid during that 10-day window. That means the partial payment amount represents 98% of the credit given. And we know what that amount is. It was 50. So in terms of a percentage problem, we have a part, we have a rate, and we're looking for a base. Solving for a base, we take part divided by the rate, and even though, again, the customer is showing at $50 debit on their accounting, the business is going to credit them with receiving $51.02 because of meeting the criteria, the 10-day discount period, and being entitled to the 2% discount. In this next problem, we have an invoice of $580, terms of 515, 5% discount if paid within 15 days, and a partial payment of $200 was made. What credit will be given? Again, to help us see how that partial payment lays out, the credit given would represent 100% less the discount. The partial payment is actually the complement of the discount, 95%. We know what that partial payment was. What we're looking for is what credit is going to be given. Where we have 100% acts as our base. We have our rate. We have our part. To find a base, we'll take part, $200 divided by the rate, gives us a credited on the business side, the person holding this invoice, they are going to record $210.53, even though $200 was the amount that was exchanged. It has to do with the accounting of that 5% discount and receiving credit for that. In this next example, mailboxes, etc., receives an invoice amounting to $672.30 with terms of 8% discount if paid in 10 days, otherwise net in 30 days, and dated as of September 1. If a partial payment of $450 is made on September 8th, find the credit given for the partial payment and the balance due on the invoice. So let's take a look at the first question that they're asking. What's the credit given? We need to determine whether they met that criteria for that 8% discount in 10 days. We aren't even given the invoice date, but we are given the as of date. So September 1 is the date of interest. We have 10 days to make a payment to be eligible for the discount, and they clearly made that by making a partial payment on September 8th. So we go forward with using our partial payment relationship of credit given less the discount equals our partial payment. And here we've done the subtraction or found the complement of that discount. 100% minus 8% gives us 92%. And we know what that partial payment is. The partial payment is acting as our part, and we have our rate. The base then is found by part divided by rate, and a credit given for this partial payment is $489.13. The second question then is asking us, what is the balance due on this invoice? In other words, the net amount remaining that's due in 30 days, we will take the original invoice amount, subtract the credit given for the $450 payment that we just found was $489.13, and it means that the balance due on this invoice is $183.17. We have one more partial payment problem here. Yogurt for You receives an invoice amounting to $263.40 with terms of 220 EOM and dated September 6th. A partial payment of $150 is made on October 14th. Find the credit given for the partial payment and the balance due on the invoice. Let's find the first part of this, the credit given for the partial payment. The terms are 2% if paid 20 days at the end of the month, and September 6th is early enough in the month, we're not going to skip the next month. So we will take 20 days into the next month. So to be eligible for that 2% discount, a payment needs to be made by October 20th. They're telling us a payment was made October 14th, so all is good. However, they only made a partial payment, and here we have the relationship of the credit given less the discount to equal that partial payment. 100% minus 2% gives us the complement, 98%, and we know what that amount is. We have a part, we have our rate, we're looking for the credit given. Base is found by part divided by rate, 150 divided by the decimal equivalency of 98% gives us a partial payment credit of $153.06. And the second question asking us the balance due on the invoice. The original invoice was $263.40. And again, even though they made a payment of $150, and that's the amount of money that was exchanging hands, we just went through the calculation giving them that discount that gives us an equivalent credit of $153.06 for that partial payment. So the balance due is $110.34.